Day 15. So you could see Hayes was going through the Amazon toy book, which it's been out, I think, like 2 or 3 years. I used to get a Toys R Us gift book. Remember that? And you could circle what you wanted. Well, now they do that. Target does one too. Sorry, I got shower hair. Did I say day 15? I said day 15. Okay. So I'm having conflicting feelings because I told her to get rid of some things so Santa can bring new things, right? And she has a lot of stuff that's like baby, she doesn't play with anymore because it's been really hard to get rid of stuff with her. I usually have to sneak it out of the house. So I made a box. They're off school today. I made a box. I said, fill the box. Let's get rid of some things. And she's putting, I think, just what's most accessible, the easiest to grab. And like one of the things she just got last year from my mom, and I knew my mom like really worked hard to find it. And I was like, you can't do that. So now I'm telling her no, but she's putting it in the box. Do I tell her no? Do I let her get rid of it? Like, how, as a parent, you know what kind of money gets spent on some of these things. How, as a parent, can you let them do this? I as a child kept like everything. Like I have some childhood toys still of my own, and then I've been much better as an adult to be able to get rid of things, although John would argue that I don't get rid of anything, but that's not true. And like there is like emotions that are attached to some of the toys, but I was really good at getting rid of her baby clothes. Like I got rid of stuff. I kept like the tiniest box of things. But how do you, how? I need advice. And I think John would just say, let her get rid of it. If she wants to get rid of it and she's choosing to, that's her choice. It's just hard for me to think like that. I think, help. I need parent help. Please. She's upstairs on a karaoke machine right now. So I told her she had to stay upstairs because it's really loud. You might be able to hear that. All right, well, I have to work and she's home and it's going to be probably a crazy day because of that. So I hope everybody's well. All right, talk to you soon. So here's that yarn I used for that hat. I'm going to make some more pumpkins. I already have some. One pumpkin here that needs some finishing, and then some pumpkin carcasses here to do some finishing. Yeah, so there's my Addy machines. I have the king size, and I have the small guy, the 22 pin. These are all yarns I bought to make things on the Addy. Like the long infinity scarves, they're really fun with those cakes. So I have those. I sold a bunch last year for Christmas presents, and yeah. Pumpkin carcasses. Fun times, right? And a wandering cat wondering what the heck's going on. Hayes, what do you got, babe?
That bowl.
How did we make that bowl? Step closer.
With newspaper, flour, and water.
Yep, paper mache, right? We're gonna spray paint them.
Yeah, I'm in my witch costume.
You are. Yeah, and I got my bowl. I trimmed mine. And Hazel left some of hers like it is and trimmed off one weird piece. And we're gonna spray paint them.
Yeah, you go first because we already have the black.
So I was on Instagram the other day and I saw this shawl called The Susanna, no, The Cow, called Susanna. And it's by Heather Booz, B-O-O-S. And I was like going through yarn and I have this lace weight that I have no clue what to do with. So I'm going to double up this lace weight. The cow, I'll insert picture somewhere, uses like a main skein and two mini skeins or two contrasty colors, and it's fingering. So I've already test this, these two together as the main color. And that looks pretty cool together. And then I'm going to use these independently as the contrast colors held double. So I need to cake these up. I think that's going to be the next thing I cast on because I like the bandana cows. I like shawls wearing them bandana style, but I always hate that they are falling off. So I think these are both gifted to me. I'm pretty sure both of these. And I had this because I bought this at a festival. And this may have been gifted too because I don't think I bought this. This is a size 6. It calls for 7. I think I am going to go up to a 7. And I have some mohair I might hold with possibly the blue to make it lighter. Because I think the green is pretty good contrast. But the blue is close. So I might I have white mohair. And instead of holding this double, holding it with the mohair. Ah! Also, Telly Bean Knits. Let me switch camera. Telly Bean Knits. I can't think of her real name. She just put her Halloween shawl. I mean, cow bandana. Another cow bandana. On sale. And it was like $2. So, guess what? I'll insert a picture here. Down below, let's have a giveaway on Vlogtober. So you have to have Ravelry for me to be able to gift it to you. And, tell me your favorite Halloween candy. Yeah, I think that'll be fun. Tell me your favorite Halloween candy, what's your favorite Halloween candy to receive, and I'll gift you that shawl. If you already have it, we'll figure something out. But I'll gift you that Halloween shawl. I think that is fun. Okay, Halloween's coming. I'm getting excited. I still need to find a dress for my costume. Eek. All right. I've done a lot of talking. We spray painted those. My finger's blue. Hers was blue. You saw me doing mine black. But it needs another coat, so it's drying. Gonna eat a beat.
Well, no, this is me being a DJ.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I guess.
I was a DJ in my earlier years. You ready?
Maybe.
Alright, let's see if I can remember how to do this. Let the beat drop.